20s and 25, 26. For me, it happened with the Sean Porter fight. Sean Porter, I fought him once that year. I fought Danny once that year. And then I had 2 years off, just had two more fights. And now I'm practically about to be coming up on a year off, and I'm trying to have another fight, you know? One fight a year is not where you need to be as an athlete. It's just way too inactive, you know? And that's why I do believe that, you know, obviously the Keith Thurman that fought Manny Pacquiao was not the greatest Keith Thurman of all times. It wasn't even the Keith Thurman of the old times, in my personal opinion. Another thing when it comes to being a monster and a beast is just acknowledging your strengths and your weaknesses. And one of them for me is my power. And I've boxed so much. I've enjoyed using my IQ and finessing victories. And for once, in the last time, I needed that knockout. And if not the knockout, at least the knockdown. But you don't get the knockdown without going for the knockout, right?
Yeah.
So I needed that. I needed, in the heat of the moment, a moment that I haven't been in for a very long time, in the heat of the moment, I needed the real do it now or never do it. And
so we're going to see more of an aggressive...
The killer was the killer wasn't in me that night, you know? Manny Pacquiao got away. The killer wasn't in me that night. And it was an awakening. It was an awakening for me. And I'm hoping to utilize that as motivation. And I think we saw it with Victor Ortiz back in the day. When Victor Ortiz beat Andre Berto, you know, he came off of a horrific loss. Not even a loss, a horrific loss. And then came back, didn't really dominate. He had his ups and downs, but put on a terrific performance. And it was because the fire was ignited again. It's because he wanted to see his own personal greatness again. You know what I mean? And that's what I'm striving for now.
So does that make you, the fact that you said that you couldn't get the knockdown against Pacquiao, does that make you more aggressive in fights now moving forward? Because, you know, there, you know, when you were coming up as a contender, it was, you were wiping guys on. As you move up in competition, naturally, they're not going to fall. That is a thing when it comes to being a prize fighter.
Yeah.
Because the level of competition is raised, yet you still pulled out victories with the exception of the loss to Pacquiao. But does that make you become more aggressive and say, okay, I have this boxing IQ, but I need to be a little bit more aggressive and start stepping more to guys like how I did when I was coming up as a contender?
Definitely. Like I keep saying, in retrospect, when I look back on my sparring, you know, I sparred way too much on my back foot and I fought way too much on my front foot, right? So how are you training on your back foot and then performing on your front foot, right? So, you know, that frustrated me a little bit. Another thing, too, is I just got to let my hands go. One of the things that didn't allow me to let my hands go is the knowledge in the back of my head. As I'm trying to hurt you, I might be hurting me, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that, I think that's what really allowed me not to pull the trigger that night. Because it's you got to go beyond another barrier. It's not even like, do I want to just swing for the fence? I'm trying to hit a home run. It's not even gathering up the courage to just swing at it, you know, at a fastball. It's not even just trying to get up that courage. But the fact that, you know, making contact might not be good for you. Making contact, you know, you need to make this contact, but making that contact might not be good for you. So having that little thing in the back of my head, I'm just learning how much of a crutch it really was, how much of a splinter. I always try to, like, nullify it, dumb it down. Of course, I had to. I got to prepare for this fight. So I'm not trying to make it into the world's biggest deal or deal or anything. But it did a lot more, you know. That's why I'm getting back into my meditation. Because even with just mental visualization prior to the fight, I think I could have performed better, you know? It's such little minute things. When you lose by 1 point, you can almost blame the world. You can blame the refs. You can blame everything, you know? So there's a lot of small things that that I believe that I could have done, that I've always wanted to do, too. I've always wanted to do it to bring the best out of myself. So now that I've I wasn't able to cheat. I wasn't able to slip away and stay at the top. Or stay undefeated, even with all my circumstances, because that could have done something to my ego. Maybe I wouldn't have gotten hand surgery. Maybe I would have said, nah, I just beat Pacquiao with this. Let me go make another paycheck, you know, tell the doctors.
So is this more a blessing than anything, Keith, in your opinion? Could this be a blessing in disguise for you, that 1-point loss at the hands of Manny Pacquiao?
A little bit, because the performance was terrific. You know, and I mean, ultimately, I still want that rematch. You know, I still, if he's going to hold on to that belt, if he wants to be the WBA super welterweight champion of the world, I still want my rematch. Because like I said, I do believe that I have all that it takes to be the biggest problem, like I once was, and I believe I always will be one of the biggest problems in the welterweight division. And I believe that I can get my position back, you know, and that's another thing that also solidifies truly great champions like Muhammad Ali. It's not about just getting in position. It's that even if you lose your position, you have what it takes to take it back, to take it right back. And that's what I would love to do after this coronavirus.
What do you want to tell all these welterweights, the guys, aside from Pacquiao, the guys like Danny Garcia, Sean Porter, Errol Spence, Terrence Crawford? Those guys are among the top of the list, along with you, at 147. What do you want to tell all of them as we move forward with Keith Thurman?
Crawford knows he can get it. I'm a very simple man when it comes to the fight world and doing business. You know what I mean? Be real. Send the contract. Watch me sign it. You know what
so
I mean?
You're saying, you're telling me that if Terrence Crawford, who is a champion right now, for some reason, if the fight with Pacquiao cannot manifest itself, but you're telling me that if Terrence Crawford and they would send a contract and say, we want Keith Thurman, if the financials are right, you'd be okay with it? You would
Of course. Next fight.
You
know? Next fight. I could debate on it, you know. Of course, I wouldn't. Part of me wouldn't like it because I would respect that Crawford is a champion who's always in shape. You know, of course, I'd want to be prepared for that. Coming off of everything that I've come off of, if it's not exactly what I want, which is the Manny Pacquiao rematch, you know, there are good fights out there that are good fights to let me reinstate some form of dominance in the welterweight division and then go right into a Crawford or Spence. That's another thing. If I'm presented with a contract, you know, if I'm presented with both at the same time, I'll go Spence over Crawford. Spence has priority over Crawford outside of the political
Yeah, not talking anything politically. I'm just asking. Yeah, I'm literally asking you.
At the end of the day, he has two belts. You know, he has more pull, more weight in the welterweight division. Terrence Crawford has done tremendous throughout his whole career. I'm still not a fan of the belt that he holds. I'm more interested in the matchup and the fight itself over being champion of that sanctioning body. But at the end of the day, you know, I love great fights. I love being champion of the world. So, you know, if I'm presented with those kind of opportunities, I'm not going to hesitate. You know, I'm not going to wait. I might take it. You know, I might take it. Right. What?
So in order of
November, birthday fight.
So in order of your wish list, it's sounding like Pacquiao's number one. Mm-hmm. Spence is number two. Crawford is number three when it comes to Keith Thurman's wish list. Is that correct?
Okay. Yes. So let's go. Major fight. Keith Thurman's back in the ring, ready to entertain the world. Pay-per-view even, you know? That has to be those three names, right?
Mm-hmm.
It has to be those three names. Now, outside of that, you know, back in the ring, Thurman versus Danny, and the winner gets an eliminator against Spence or Pacquiao. Obviously, it wouldn't be a Crawford for political reasons, right?
Yeah.
So, if that's the case, you know, then so be it. And that not only is that a great match, not only is that a great rematch, but then it would lead into another great fight, possible Pacquiao rematch or Spence. And then, you know, so I just see that that's the kind of boat that I'm in. I either do something that's really nice for now that leads into something great, or let's just do it. Let's just do the dang thing. Let's just do another great event. I have to admit, I'm a little addicted to big shows. You know, I mean, there's just an energy. There's just a liveliness to it. I get fully satisfied from being a part of such a big event. The fans get so much satisfaction. And then I just deliver with the entertainment, and it is what it is.
How much longer, how do you feel in terms of your career wise, how much longer do you want to go in your career? Because in my opinion, I feel like you're in the prime of your career right now. How much longer have you thought about that? Or is it like, let me go as long as I can? I mean, fighters have different perspectives. Some guys say I'm done before 40. Other guys say, you know, a certain financial amount. For Keith Thurman, have you thought about how long you want to go? Or is that not even in your perspective right now?
Oh, yeah. You know, I've never really been a big fan of, like, going to, like, you know, 38 or 37, those kind of numbers. You know, I would like to get the job done a little sooner than that. Get all the big fights that I want, and just leave knowing that I did my best in the sport that I love. And then, you know, sit aside alongside you and, you know, work the fights or something, you know. But for right now, it's just year by year. And, you know, last year I went through it in pain. Now I'm no longer in pain. I'm hoping to withstand that. I'm hoping to withstand my health, and hoping to squeeze, you know, at least right now start. We must continue for 3 more years. You know, we got 3 more years, and we just got to look at our health. So pretty much, I think, like, once when I'm 31 now, so it's like every 2 or 3 years, you just got to check yourself and just make sure, like, hey, you healthy? You really up for this? Can you really do it? You know? You can still run 8 miles, you know? Okay, let's go. So we'll see. But I think 35 is kind of like a good
done. It's a good number for you.
Yeah, I think it's kind of done. It's lived a life, you know? I turned pro at 19 years old. So, you know, you can't do it forever. Maybe I will push it. Maybe this injury is the last injury I'll ever suffer, and we'll just strengthen my body, and I'll work with a lot of physical therapists, and maybe I'll be strong and healthy at 37, still in the ring. But that's not the end game.
I'd be okay with that.
the end game would be sooner. But if I can do it, I'll do it, man. I would love to. There's been athletes like Bernard Hopkins who did it for much longer. But you know, the welterweight division is just such a talent filled division. And then, you know, you get all sorts of different shapes and sizes of monstrous guys. You get these 6-footers, you get all these different shapes and sizes from, and we got a whole bunch of new talent that's going to be coming up. I'm excited for the world of boxing. You know, I was really looking forward to the Olympics, you know, but as long as they're just carrying it 1 year, we still have something to look forward to next year. It's still going to be a summer games. It's unfortunate. I really was looking forward to going to Tokyo. But hopefully I will be able to be there next year. Regardless, I want to see the young talent. I want to see the young athletes. And just support boxing and then get it and mark it off my bucket list, you know, Olympics. Always wanted to attend.
Well, you and I both, Keith, as we get ready to let you go, we appreciate the time. What do you want to tell all your fans and fans of boxing as we continue to deal with the coronavirus all over the world? We can't wait to see you back inside the ring along with the rest of your constituents and those that are, you know, world-class prize fighters, because, man, I miss it. I assume that you miss it as well, and cannot wait to see you guys perform at the highest level, which you so eloquently do.
Yeah. I mean, you know, I'm pretty sure people are going to be